SCP-2375. Object Class, Euclid. Special Containment Procedures. Due to the widespread nature of SCP-2375, permanent containment is currently not feasible. Instead, Mobile Task Force Zeta-28, Army of Darkness, has been created for the sole purpose of identifying and terminating active colonies of instances of SCP-2375-1, as well as working to prevent activities that would result in the spread of SCP-2375, if an instance of SCP-2375-1 is discovered in a populated area where it is possible for SCP-2375 to spread. MTF Zeta-28 is to be dispatched immediately and must investigate the targeted area for possible colonies of SCP-2375-2 instances. Should a colony of SCP-2375-2 be discovered, agents of MTF Zeta-28 are instructed to eliminate any points of access for instances of SCP-2375-2 to exit the area. Any further remaining instances of SCP-2375-1 or SCP-2375-2 are to be terminated immediately. TTT. Description: SCP-2375 is a necrotic skin condition in its beginning stages, capable of spreading through physical contact. Initial symptoms of SCP-2375 include mild decay of the skin on the chest, increased senses of euphoria and pleasure, and a decreased ability to feel pain. Within 1 week, this skin damage grows in size and intensity until the affected part of the body begins to resemble severely necrotic skin, although those infected with SCP-2375 report no unusual feelings. The bodies of individuals infected with SCP-2375 display no permanent damage to the insides of the body, appearing to suffer only physical decay. Approximately 2 weeks after the individual is first infected with SCP-2375, the infection will spread to the individual's limbs, if available, and lower torso. Individuals who reach this point of infection are designated instances of SCP-2375-1. The subject will then attempt to convince bystanders to initiate physical contact with the subject in order to spread SCP-2375. Humans with antisocial personality disorders are particularly susceptible to SCP-2375-1's influence. SCP-2375-1 instances have been shown to engage in standard fundraising activities, such as door-to-door recruiting, distribution of mail leaflets. See transcript of 2375-1 distributed flyer, social events, and group therapy programs to gain opportunities to spread SCP-2375 to humans who participate in these events. Participants in these events report a strong compulsion to interact with instances of SCP-2375-1 that remains for approximately 3 hours after the conclusion of the event. Aside from containing instances of SCP-2375-1, usually dressed in elaborate costumes or long clothing, no anomalous activity or atypical spread of SCP-2375 has been reported during these events. Plus display transcript of SCP-2375-1 example flyer. Hide. Hello friend, are you feeling lonely? Depressed? Persecuted? We all feel like that sometimes. But don't worry. We can help you. Do you want to make new friends? Of course you do. We all do. That's why we here at your local Fun Life Association want to help you make them. We're cordially inviting you to an ice cream social at Data Redacted at noon tomorrow. Here you'll meet people from around the community, enjoy some ice cream, and maybe meet some new friends. Here's to a world where we can all just get along. Yours truly, your local Fun Life branch, Fun Life. Here, we're all the same. Once an instance of SCP-2375-1 has spread SCP-2375, it will attempt to retreat to a small, readily available 5x5 hole within 100 kilometers of the area, or to create one if one is not readily available. These holes have been shown to lead to small, subterranean caverns inhabited by mass quantities of SCP-2375-1 instances. These caverns are identified by instances of SCP-2375-1 as villages, and consist of several small buildings that serve various purposes, see Interview Log 2375A. Any instance of SCP-2375-1 that is seen entering a village has not been shown to emerge again. Once in these villages, instances of SCP-2375-1 enter the final stage of transformation into an instance of SCP-2375-2. Underground, the subject's face begins experiencing a rapid decomposition similar to the rest of the body. This is considered the final stage of infection with SCP-2375, as no further damage to the body has been noticed. No instances of SCP-2375-2 after the final stage of decomposition have been seen to willingly re-emerge from their subterranean caverns, nor have any made an attempt during Foundation raids, plus display experiment log 2375A, hide experiment log 2375A, access granted. Welcome, Site Director, with the approval of 5 members of the O5 Council, 1D class personnel was permitted to be used by Site Director Pembroke as a test subject to analyze the inner workings of a normal human infected by SCP-2375 as well as investigate the inner workings of a village inhabited solely by instances of SCP-2375-1. An instance of SCP-2375-1 was detained by Foundation agents in the neighborhood of Redacted, Kansas, and successfully contained for the purpose of the experiment in a standard humanoid containment cell at Site 77. D-2375-82, an African-American male who suffers from clinical depression, was introduced into a testing chamber containing the captured instance, Conversation Log 2375A. D-2375-82 introduced to testing chamber within site radius of SCP-2375-1 instance, D-2375-82 sits in testing chamber. Subject is approached by SCP-2375-1 instance, SCP-2375-1 approaching D-2375-82, what's wrong, pal? You look a little down, D-2375-82, of course I'm down, you freak. I'm stuck in here as part of someone's freak experiment. I wish I had never taken this over staying in death row. Fuck off, I've got nothing else to say to you, SCP-2375-1, I know how you feel, man, D-2375-82, how the hell could you, SCP-2375-1, the folks up in the observation deck put me in here too. But that's fine with me. Look around. We've got a nice room and each other, what more could we need? D-2375-82, what are you talking about? SCP-2375-1, I've been where you are. You're depressed, aren't you? I can see it in your eyes. I used to be like that too. But I changed, and now I'm happier than ever, D-2375-82, what happened, SCP-2375-1, I found a place. A wonderful place. A place filled with people just like me. And just like you, D-2375-82 is told to continue questioning SCP-2375-1 instance, D-2375-82, how do I get there? SCP-2375-1, I can take you. Don't worry. You'll be safe there. Shake my hand, friend. D-2375-82 is instructed to shake hands with the SCP-2375-1 instance, SCP-2375-1, welcome to the unlife, brother. Shortly after this conversation, both the instance of SCP-2375-1 and D-2375-82 were removed from testing and placed in separate containment. Post-testing psychiatric screening of D-2375-82 reports significantly increased levels of euphoria and optimism. 1 week after D-2375-82's contact with the SCP-2375-1 instance, a routine physical examination, provided by Foundation agents in hazmat equipment, revealed patches of skin on the arms and chest bearing qualities similar to those of advanced necrosis. After this physical examination, a psychiatric examination was conducted by Dr. Pembroke to determine the extent of SCP-2375's control over the brain. Dr. Pembroke, how are you feeling? D-2375-82, D-2375-82, not gonna lie, Doc. I've never felt this good. Something about that guy just rubbed me right, you know, Dr. Pembroke, our physicians have detected severe damage on areas of your skin. Do you notice anything strange about your arms, D-2375-82, oh, the skin? That's nothing big. Just a small price to pay for the opportunity to feel a little better. That guy you introduced me to helped me to see that, Dr. Pembroke, can you explain further? What exactly drew you to the instance, D-2375-82, there was something about him. The way he talked. The way he listened. No matter how rude I was, he didn't get mad. It was almost like he understood, Dr. Pembroke, understood what, D-2375-82, everything, Doc. I would say the cruelest things, and he sat there smiling and nodding. He listened to every word I said. There was some feeling in me that made me feel like I could trust him. He was just, nice, you know, Dr. Pembroke, what made you feel this way? D-2375-82, well. It just felt like he cared. He wanted to help me. He had the voice and tone that made me feel like I could tell him everything. So, when the researchers told me to test his patience, I broke down and told him everything. All my stories from the streets, and he didn't bat an eye. It came to the point that I broke down. But he didn't laugh like most of you do. He knelt down and pat me on the back, told me it was okay. He made me feel all right, where nobody else bothers to. Dr. Pembroke, what do you feel now that he has been removed from the testing area? D-2375-82, I don't feel lonely. I don't feel bad. To tell the truth, I feel like I have a new friend. Approximately 3 weeks after initial infection of D-2375-82, the subject was equipped with a video camera and two-way headset for the purpose of gathering information regarding the underground habitats of instances of SCP-2375-1. D-2375-82 was instructed to follow the test instance of SCP-2375-1 into a small hole located 30 kilometers west of Site 77. The following is a transcript of the recovered footage, Dr. Pembroke, D-2375-82, can you hear me, D-2375-82, loud and clear, big man. Following James now, Dr. Pembroke, James. Is that the instance's name, D-2375-82, yeah, I never told you that. Oh, hold up. We're coming to something. It looks like, a little town. Dr. Pembroke, a town? Can you explain, D-2375-82, yeah. It looks like a little slum village. They've got houses made of sticks and rocks that must have fallen down the holes. Some of these look like shops. I think I can see what looks like a diner. Hell, there's even a little park with some that look like kids, Dr. Pembroke. Do you notice anything strange about the village, D-2375-82, not really. Other than the skin thing you told me about, SCP-2375-1, this way, Jamal. I've got some friends I want you to meet, D-2375-82, coming. Sorry, Doc, I'll get back to you later, SCP-2375-82 proceeds to set the video camera down and run towards several instances of SCP-2375-1. Loud laughter and light conversation can be heard for roughly 30 minutes before audio feed cuts out, roughly 5 hours after the initial encounter with other instances of SCP-2375-1. The audio feed was resumed and the video camera was turned on by D-2375-82. The following is a transcript of the final recording from D-2375-82, Level 5 clearance required, D-2375-82, hey, is this thing on? Can you hear me, Doc, Doctor? Pembroke, D-2375-82. D-2375-82, yep, it's me. I said I would get you back. If there's one thing I can do, it's keep a promise. But listen, I wanted to talk to you. I want you let me go, Doctor. Pembroke, excuse me, D-2375-82, you won't believe this, but it's wonderful down here. I haven't even been around a day and they're already treating me like their best friend. They built me my own little house. They took me to dinner. We talked and laughed. I've been all over the town and haven't seen a single fight. I don't think I've seen people with so little smile so much, Doctor. Pembroke, can you explain, D-2375-82, I finally understand what this group is all about. They're not trying to take over the world, or destroy us all or whatever you guys believe they'll do. I'm sorry, we just want to live in peace, Doctor. Pembroke, live in peace? What does that mean, D-2375-82, I've talked to the people down here. We all just wanted to get away from something. I've met people who were abused and beaten, but who can put it all behind it here. It's a place we can all forget our troubles and comfort each other. Where we're all the same. The skin condition is proof of that, Doctor. Pembroke, the skin condition, D-2375-82, it's brilliant, actually. So many of us here have been prejudiced because of what we look like or what we believe. But now, thanks to Fun Life, we don't have to worry about that. When we're all the same, nobody has anything to fight over. We can focus on what brings us together rather than what keeps us apart. Listen, Doc. I know your foundation doesn't normally do this, but please. Just leave us be. If not for me, then for everyone else down here, Doctor. Pembroke, you are aware that the foundation is not able to permit the actions of your group. You realize you cannot continue to abduct citizens as you do, D-2375-82, all we want is to help others escape like we have. I've got nothing more to say if you won't listen. Goodbye, document, as a publication, there has been no further communication with D-2375-82 or any instance of SCP-2375-1 within a 300-kilometer radius of any Foundation site. Due to the nature of SCP-2375, containment procedures have been downgraded from immediate termination to the process of sealing clusters of SCP-2375-1 instances to prevent spread of the infection. At time of this revision, downgrade of SCP-2375 to neutralized status is pending review by the O5 Council.